Hello everybody, and for today's Jurassic World Evolution video, tour video, we'll be exploring my Jurassic Park River Cruise style park. Now for this park, it was inspired based off, you know, Jurassic Park, the segment in the novel where the T-Rex is chasing our characters through the River Cruise, and also it's inspired off the Universal Studios ride, and also in the Jurassic Park film, because canonically there's going to be a river cruise in Jurassic Park, you know, if it fully opens and such. And also in Jurassic World, there's also a river cruise style thing, but, you know, different era for a different time. So this tour's going to be based off Jurassic Park River Cruise, which is obviously the name of the park. Why am I going in circles? Nobody's going to know. So let's get on the tour. Now this tour is kind of like, it's not its own park exactly. When I was thinking of this park, I used it as like, this is like a different part of Jurassic Park. So you know my Jurassic Park tour video I did a while ago? This is kind of like if you were on a different part of the island. Like, you know, that's the main tour over there. And then by helicopter, which if you come over here, you'd fly in by helicopter from the main Jurassic Park and fly to this other side of the island where you would take the tour for the river cruise, because river cruise kind of acts like its own segment of the park. So you would start here, you know, flying from Jurassic Park, you enjoy your day, helicopter, you know, perfect on timing. You would land, you know, do all your stuff here, get off. There'd be a restroom right here for you to use, also two restrooms actually. You'd come this way, here's in case you were hungry, your Jurassic cafes, and your Jurassic gifts right here. Two gift shops. That's the main entrance of the tour, but we'll get on that in a second. You come this way, along this little waterway. Obviously, this is a river cruise, so we gotta have a lot of water, don't we? too much throat clearing. We have another restrooms, two restrooms to be exact. Come along this way, and we have our three hotels. You know what I realized while I was rewatching some of my stuff, that I usually put down three hotels. I don't know why I do that. Just three, like a good just set number of hotels. So there's three hotels for our guests here to use if they wanted to stay here instead of the main part of the park, I should say. Come over this way, here's our weather control station. Not our control of the weather, but our weather forecast, I should say. And our ranger station right here, the ranger of the park and everything and such. Now you would come over here this way. And yeah, that's it. It's like I said, it's a very small segment, because this isn't meant to be its own park. It's meant to be a segment of the Jurassic Park I built a while ago. So give us a moment, folks, and we're gonna hop into the actual Jurassic tour vehicles, and I'm gonna show you around the actual physical river cruise. Now, also part of this river cruise is obviously there's no boats in the game I could use for a river cruise. Because, you know, a river cruise needs a boat to go down the stream, or a river. So, I had to use the Jurassic Park tour vehicles, and as you can see along here. Now, obviously, it gets to water. Over here, it's not really water, because the land is kind of messed up. But over the hill, it goes into a little more of a watery area. So, over here now, it's like land. You know, you get your tour vehicle started. You come across, you go, like, down the track. And then you actually get into the watery river cruise area. Now, you'll see what I mean by, like, the track, because obviously the track has to go across the water. And you'll see how I kind of manage that, like, little effect. So I will be back in a minute when we're in the tour vehicle. Alright, folks, and now we're in the actual tour vehicle where you would begin the tour. So this is our tour vehicle, the standard Jurassic Park car. So you come over this way. There's some water to our left and our right over here. Now, when building this park, I try to build more of a claustrophobic, like the jungle closing in you, like closing in on you type feeling, until you got to like the more open, vast waterways. But even with the waterways, there are some some like strangling like parts. So as you just saw, you'd come down this big hill over here. You know what? Actually, since I was talking that whole time, let's back reverse over this hill and then come back over it. So you'd come speeding down this hill over here, and then you see this is what I meant by the waterway like type feel. because there's no boats in the game. You can't drive through the water. You can, but like you can't drive through the water like on a tour. I created it so it's like you're going through a thin piece of land that goes through the river on the tour track, so that you are in the vehicles in the middle of the river. But it's a river cruise, but you're not really in the water. So you see what I did there. So we have our iconic Jurassic Park gates we'd come through. What they got in there? King Kong? See what I did there? Ian Malcolm? No? Okay, let's keep going. So, you'd come along this way into our Brachiosaurus Cove area. See water on both sides. We're going down a jungle river. You'd come over this way. Our Brachiosaurus. Or over there. It's a little hill over there. It's a little open right there. Have our brachies have enough room to kind of get their legs stretched and such without being in water. Or like over there with a little small piece of land that dips down. Oh, excuse me. Come along this way. Look at that beautiful shot. Here, let's go third person real quick. This feels iconic. This always reminds me that, of course, I would kind of do this like based off the Universal Jurassic Park ride. Also, canonically, Jurassic Park would have a river cruise because they said they would in the movie. Or not said they would, but there's art in the background in one of the scenes where they're having lunch. We come over this way. This would be our Brachiosaurus Cove. Now, just so we don't get slowed down here, let's go around these folks. Just a little bit of a fast pass, I guess you could call it. So you'd come this way from our brachies into, I believe, if I remember building this correctly like I did, into our Stegosaurus little river section. So you drive down over here, and look at that. Our Stegosaurus are, you know, crossing the riverway as soon as you come in. Beautiful shot. Let's come over here. And this feeling, I wanted to open up a little bit here, but also on the other side to have the jungle be, you know, claustrophobic, like I said. Because Jurassic Park in itself, she was a little claustrophobic. I don't know if you guys got that feeling from the movie, but it's a little bit claustrophobic and like suspenseful with the jungle and the dinosaurs, like that mystery feeling. So I kind of wanted to recreate that in the tour vehicle as you're going down like this river cruise, like that suspense, that mystery of what's around the corner is the feeling I wanted to try to recreate here. So I just let our Stegos pass by here. Can I sneak past you? No? Uh-oh. We might have a little bit of a problem here. Uh-oh.
Warning. I think I'm stuck. Tour vehicle under attack.
Please? Can't move. Wait. Oh, there we go. Oh, our Stegos are,
Stegosaurus roamed the
Morrison
Formation, a semi-arid region.
Well, that just happened. Hey, look, I said the park was going to be fun, the river cruise would be fun, but I didn't say it would be safe all entirely. Good thing these parks are built out, or these parks, these cars are built of, like, titanium. Also, up there on top of the screen, you probably see that dinosaur threat. Of course, this whole ride isn't just going to be herbivores, there will be carnivores. So, prepare for a little danger and excitement, I guess you could call it, if you would like to call it that, of course. So we're done with our Stego endeavor right there. You come through. Now in here there's a little bit of a breather. There's no dinosaurs in this section, but it's just like you see the river on both sides of you. I mean this whole tour is a lot of dinosaurs, jungle, and water, as you could probably tell at this point. So you'd come over this way. Turn the left here. Nice array of palm trees growing to our right. A little bit of that sandy beach next to the river to our left. Now you come through here, and here's our first carnivores on the tour, which are our Dilophosaurus. So you drive through here. A little bit of that claustrophobic feeling to the left, but not exactly. No, I wanted it to be claustrophobic, but I also want space for our dinosaurs to breathe and move around in our park. So I had to do like a balance of it. I think it went pretty well. I believe I put four or three dilos in here. You see they're crossing the riverways and such. Nice little enclosure, not too big, not too small. Perfect size. Right there's our goat feeder. If there's a goat on it, you'd probably see it. We come this way, past our Dilos, Dilos, Dilophosaurus, many names for just one creature. Come along this way, to our left, a little bit of a breather again, not a lot here. It's just like a little passing area, or a passing area before you get into the more dinosaurs. A little bit of a hill to our left over here, or left to create some variety. Wait, did I say that right? Yeah, variety. Why? I'm not the best with words. And as you can see here, by our park not being, or our river cruise not being, you know, the safest, our tour vehicle to our right over here is bashed up. Once again, fun, but not the safest. But, I mean, that's why you signed a waiver to come on the river cruise. Not really, you didn't really, but let's just imagine you did so I don't get sued. So you'd come around here, and here's our Parasaurolophus? Yeah, Parasaurolophus. Once again, not the greatest with words. So, it's a little bumpy right here. The tour track goes a little bit up and down, as you can tell. So here's our Parasaurolophus. Jungly riverway. You see the trees start going onto the actual, like, water. They create that claustrophobic feeling, like I kind of want it. Also that mystery feeling. Our paras. They come in browns and they come in greens on the river cruise. Whoa, you did it all over the place. Jeez, that Parasaurolophus probably has Tourette's, huh? So, you come over here. This is the end of our Parasaurolophus area. A bit more jungle and river cruise. Now you come over through this way. Come through this way. Once again, another breathing area, but, you know, very claustrophobic at the same time to create that mystery and that, like, sense of danger, and you'll get why sense of danger in a minute as you come over this steep hill incline. You see, it gets very choked in by the jungle right here. A dark and, like, eerie feeling. Now we come in here, and we have our Baryonyx. Baryonyx was in Jurassic Park, not in the movie, but it was in the advertisement material map in the actual film that was used for advertising. So, put a Baryonyx in here. Now, once again, the jungle starts closing in on the water, creating that, like, swampy, jungly type feeling that I want for this enclosure. Hopefully we can get a shot of our Baryonyx in here. Oh, speaking of our shot of Baryonyx, there's one drinking over there. Very hard to see. There's two in here. There's a fish feeder over there for the fish to feed. Fish to feed? I meant to say the Baryonyx to feed. Because we're feeding the fish to the Baryonyx. The fish aren't here to be in the park as actual attractions. As you can see, we're getting a very close-up shot of our Baryonyx. He's a fish feeder, so hopefully he doesn't attack the car. Oh. So there's our park resident Baryonyx. There's another one. I don't think we're gonna see him. Oh, he's over there. Yep. Uh-oh. Folks, we're gonna have a problem here. We're just gonna get going. Alright. He's still following. Yep, he's still following. I'll just get to a safe position over this way. Well, now he's not gonna be able to grab us. Oh, and he's taking a nap. Sorry for that possible weird cut we just had to take. I had to reset the recording software. So, I mean, we're all back now. Yeah, it's gonna be a weird cut right there. I'll probably have to place in. Alright, so we come over here. It opens up a little bit right here. This little waterways over here. A little pond to our right and our left. And a little pond up there, which connects to the rest of the actual tour. That pond goes on to a different pond, or to a different river that's not part of the tour. So now we come in through here. And we have our Triceratops and Styracosaurus. Now Styracosaurus was in Jurassic Park. Once again, it was in the material, not in the actual film. Also, I believe it was in the novel. So the Styracosaurus and the Triceratops, I thought they're close enough. Both ceratopsids, so I put them in the same enclosure. So there's our Styracosaurus all the way in the back with our Triceratops in the front over here. As you can see, a lot more clear to see. Triceratops. Here's two of our Triceratops crossing the river.
Triceratops lived at the same so majestic, time as T-Rex. They were mortal enemies then, and they remain so too.
Jeez, the Triceratops just screams Jurassic Park. So does everything in this game, because everything is in this movie is in this game is Jurassic Park and Jurassic World, but I mean, just so iconic to the first movie. So is the Brachiosaurus and everything too. And there's our Styracosaurus over there. Not a great view, but I mean, we gotta stick with the tour track. But there's our Styracosaurus. Just grazing and chilling over there. This is a little bit more of an open area because I wanted our dinosaurs to breathe. They don't want to be so claustrophobic in this part of the tour. Trust me, it's about to get a little more claustrophobic, I think. That's it over here. Come along the tour way. Once again, this eerie feeling, as I keep stating throughout the whole video. Jungle's closing in on you. You're going through the river. Going down the cruiseway. I don't even know what a cruiseway is. I'm just coming up with words and phrases at this point. So it gets a little bumpy over here. Up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Alright, and as we go down the river, we come across our third carnivore of the tour, which are our park velociraptors. Now the velociraptors, I will say, cause the most damage of the tour. When I was setting up this park, velociraptors, every single time a tour vehicle would come past, the velociraptors would try to ruin the tour. So don't be surprised if we get jumped here a little bit. So to our left and our right is our velociraptor. Well, not to our right, mostly. Mostly just, jungle and water, like usual. But to our left is our velociraptors. Now, did you guys know in the novel, when they're going down, wait, is it? I can't remember if it's in the tour or if it's in the river, like the riverboat scene. But there's a velociraptor that went camo. It was like, it flew past. I think Alan Grant saw it, if I remember correctly. I can't remember. I haven't read the novel in like a while. But they see a camouflaging velociraptor that runs past them. And this is mostly what I thought about when I was building this enclosure, was that camouflaging velociraptor. So yeah, just a little bit of inside my mind while I was building this. Now the velociraptors are running, and I really hope that doesn't mean they're trying to kill us. Let's hope not. Where'd that one go behind us? Oh. He's trying to- Oh! Yep, I knew it. What is an up close shot of our velociraptors in there? Imagine if I was in first person. That would have been a lot better, huh? So there's our velociraptors on the tour. Four of them, compared to in the actual park. There is three. Come over this way. And this will be our final attraction of the tour, of the river cruise. You come over this winding hill up here. This is the highest elevated part of the park. This whole part of the park over here is elevated above the rest. And this is where our resident Tyrannosaurus Rex is. The dinosaur threat, don't know what that could be. Let's hope it's not the T-Rex right now. Speaking of T-Rex down there drinking water, I think. But also this T-Rex, as you will see here, is like a reddish brownish type color. And that's because in the novel, there was actually two Tyrannosauruses. There was the brown one, which, Rexy, T-Rex, that's the most iconic. Then also there was this reddish darkish one. I think the reddish darkish one was the older one, if I remember correctly, or the younger. I think it was the older. The red darkish one was older, so as like a reference, I picked the reddish darkish one, which I also think is a reference, the skin itself, to the novel's Tyrannosaurus Rex, because there was two in the novel, as I said. See, like a darkish red, like whitish underbelly type color. So that's meant to. I put that skin in here as like a reference, because also that T-Rex is part of the river raft scene, where the T-Rex chases the boat they're driving on down the river. So you come down this way, opens up a little bit, kind of signifies the end of the tour. Drive down over here. Then you get a final little suspenseful moment as you drive down this hill. You come down here, and yay, you survived. Now you can go buy a t-shirt at our local gift shops. So yeah, that's the end of the tour. That would be it. As I said, it's not... I think this is a pretty good park I built. I did definitely did have fun, because I usually have fun building the Jurassic Park. But I definitely think there are some parts I could have done better on. But I think this park was okay. I enjoyed building it. So, I mean, yeah, and you know, it's worth sharing. So obviously this video's out. So I mean, I obviously don't think it's that bad. Oh, we made it just in time. Park tour. Oh, yep, and that's the T-Rex destroying a tour vehicle. Well, you know, at least it wasn't us, because we were just in there. And that concludes our Jurassic Park River Cruise tour. Now, I enjoyed building this park. I wanted to try to aim for a iconic, you know, old type feeling of this park. You know, try to capture that Jurassic Park feeling without it actually being the Jurassic Park tour. A Jurassic Park River Cruise is, you know, embedded into the Jurassic Park and Jurassic World, I guess, lore. Like that River Cruise type feeling. And I wanted to try to capture that in-game. Did it come out the best? Sadly, no, because we had to use vehicles instead of actual boats. But I think it came out okay. That Brachiosaurus with the iconic Jurassic Park gates. Kind of this feeling I wanted to aim for. That old classic feeling. Now, I thought I did pretty good on this park. And if you thought I did pretty good on this park, a like and a subscribe would be pretty appreciated. Comment down below for other ideas I could try to aim for on park builds. Now, I'm trying to move to 2 videos a week because it's summertime now. So I might have a little more space to start doing videos. So maybe like probably a gameplay a week and also a Jurassic World Evolution tour per week is what I want to try to shoot for. So yeah, that's really it. It's kind of just a little update on future plans I want to shoot for. Now, yeah, that was it. You made it to the end of the video. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and peace out.